Today we're on pages 190 and 191, lesson 7, the quadratic formula. You want to have your calculator available. First, we want to simplify each of the following expressions. We have 3 plus or minus the square root of 11 divided by 6. So what we want to do is we want to split this up. There are two terms in the numerator, and we want to divide each term by 6. We have 3/6 plus or minus the square root of 11 over 6. And 3 over 6 reduces to 1/2 plus or minus the square root of 11 over 6. This is simplified. Next, 3 plus or minus the square root of 50 all divided by 6. Same thing. Split this up. Kind of do this what I call a broken heart. Splitting this up, we have 3/6 plus or minus, and the same step, I'm going to simplify the square root of 50, thinking 25 times 2 is 50, and the square root of 25 is 5. So 5 square root of 2. The 3/6 reduce to 1/2, plus or minus, and the 5 square root of 2 over 6 does not simplify any further. Three plus or minus the square root of 72 all over 6. Again, think of this as a broken heart. You're splitting this up into two separate fractions. So I have 3/6 plus or minus. The square root of 72 simplifies to 36 times 2 is 72, and the square root of 36 is 6. So that is 6 square root of 2. The 3/6 simplifies to 1/2. Plus or minus, and these sixes here divide out, so we're left with simply square root of 2. So 1/2 plus or minus the square root is 2. And, oh, this last one here, we have 3/6 plus or minus, the square root of 25 is 5/6. Right now, when we're adding or subtracting fractions, we need a common denominator. So I'm not going to reduce the 3/6 here, but rather I'm going to keep it. And let's say we have 3/6 plus 5/6, which is 8/6, which reduces to dividing each by 2, 4 over 3. And 3/6 minus 5/6. Is negative 2/6, which reduces to negative 1/3. So these are in simplest form. In the last lesson, we solved the following quadratic, x squared minus 10x plus 23 equals 0, which we did on page 187. It was exercise number 3a. By completing the square, and we arrived at these solutions of x equals 5, plus or minus the square root of 2. That's how we left our answer, 5 plus or minus the square root of 2. Okay, now we want to use the quadratic formula to solve that same equation. Right? And everyone's familiar with the quadratic formula. You had it back in Algebra 1, and it is on your reference sheet. But being at the level of math you are now, you should memorize the quadratic formula. You should not have to refer to your reference sheet to look at that formula. All right. So the quadratic formula is this. For any quadratic equation in standard form, ax squared plus bx plus c equals 0. And a cannot be 0, because if that were the case, we would not have a quadratic equation, because the exponent 2 would not be there. It would simply be a linear equation. X is equal to negative b plus or minus the square root of b squared minus 4ac all over 2a. And the you may have sang the song back in Algebra 1. X equals negative b plus or minus the square root of b squared minus 4ac all over 2a. All right, enough of my singing. So using the quadratic formula, let's solve this. Our a value is 1, the coefficient of x squared. B is negative 10 and c is 23. So if we want, we can write this off to the side. A equals 1, b equals negative 10. C, our constant, is 23. Please write down the formula. It's going to help you to memorize it. Negative b plus or minus the square root b squared minus 4ac all over 2a. We make our substitutions, and I always use parentheses as placeholders. So I say, okay, negative parentheses for b plus or minus the square root of b squared. So parentheses squared minus 4 times parentheses all over 2 times parentheses. Okay, so in these first two parentheses goes the b value, negative 10. And then following the 4 is the a value 1, and down in the denominator following the 2 is the a value 1. And c is at the very end, 23. Now simplifying, negative negative 10 is positive 10. Use a different color here. There's not much room, I apologize. So x equals positive 10 plus or minus the square root of, and you can use the calculator for this piece under here. Do not use radical, right? Do not put in square root, but simply take parentheses negative 10 squared minus 4 times 1 times 23 is 8. X equals, we're going to split this up just as we did in our first, or in the first block above. So this is 10 over 2 plus or minus the square root of 8. Let's simplify that. 4 times 2 is 8, and the square root of 4 is 2. So 2 square root of 2 over 2. And simplifying, 10 divided by 2 is 5, plus or minus, and these 2's here on the divide out. We never divide a whole number or an integer into a radical. It's these 2 right here. These divide out. Plus or minus the square root of 2. Okay, so we got the same answer when we solved it by using complete the square and using the quadratic formula. So the quadratic formula can always be used. Complete the square can be used as long as the leading coefficient is not, or sorry, as long as the leading coefficient is 1. How can we tell from your solutions that the quadratic equation x squared minus 10x plus 23 equals 0 is not factorable? Because our solutions contain an irrational number. The plus or minus square root of 2. Square root of 2 is an irrational number. Which of the following represents the solutions to the equation x squared minus 10x plus 20 equals 0? There are no factors of 20 that add to negative 10. Not a positive 20. I'm thinking, there isn't anything. Anyway, I'm not going to use quadratic formula there. I'm going to use complete the square. That's my preference. The leading coefficient is 1. So, x squared minus 10x plus blank equals negative 20 plus blank. And what goes into blank is negative 5 squared, which is 25. The trinomial here, the left-hand side factors into x minus 5 squared. And the right-hand side, negative 20 and 5 is positive 5. We square root each side. We have x minus 5 equals plus or minus the square root of 5. Add 5 to both sides. X equals positive 5 plus or minus square root of 5. Choice 4. So although the quadratic formula is most helpful when a quadratic expression is prime, not factorable, it can be used as a replacement for the zero product law in cases where the quadratic can be factored. In other words, you can use the quadratic formula for any quadratic equation you are looking to solve. So exercise number 3, we want to solve the quadratic equation shown below in two different ways, A by factoring and B using the quadratic formula. Okay, so if we're factoring here, the leading coefficient is 2, it's greater than 1, so this is where we do the rainbow. Here's my rainbow, here we go. We're going to multiply 2 times negative 6 and get negative 12. And now we want the factors of negative 12 that sum to positive 11, and that would be positive 2. Where was I? That would be positive 12 and negative 1, rather. This is where we replace positive 11x with positive 12x minus 1x. So this is our grouping, 4 terms. We split, bring down the operator, take out the GCF of the first 2 terms. And you can certainly pause the video and do this on your own and then fast forward. And here, a 1 is common, but it's a negative 1 that is coming out. So we have x plus 6 times 2x minus 1 as our factors. And now we set each factor equal to 0. And if you want to go right to the answers, the values of x, you can. So subtract 6. X equals negative 6. I'm going to add 1 and divide by 2. X equals 1 half. So there are two solutions or two values for x. Now we want to take the same quadratic equation and solve it using the quadratic formula. So this is A, B, and C. X equals negative B plus or minus the square root of B squared minus 4AC all over 2A. So again, this is where I use parentheses as placeholders for our variables A, B, and C. The first 2 parentheses is the B value, 11. Following the 4 and the 2 in the denominator is the A value, 2. And negative C is at the end in the numerator. Okay, simplifying this. We have negative 11 plus or minus the square root of, and again, you can put that into the calculator. If you're not good with working this out mentally, use your calculator. And where you're putting in 11 squared minus 4 times 2 times negative 6. That is a perfect square. Its square root is 13. So I'm breaking it up and in the same time simplifying the radical. And now since we have 2 fractions here, I'm going to leave this and let's say negative 11 quarters plus 13 quarters, right? Because there's 2 things here. There's a plus 13 quarters and there's a minus 13 quarters. Okay, so plus 13 is going to give us 2 quarters, which is equivalent to a half. And minus 13 from a negative 11 is negative 24 quarters, which is equivalent to negative 6. So you see we get the same 2 answers as we did when we factored it. Where will the function f of x equals 2x squared plus 11x minus 6 intersect the x-axis? at our x values here at negative 6 and 1 half. Okay, so yep, quadratic formula is very useful in algebra. You should commit it to memory. Solve each of the following quadratic equations by using the quadratic formula. Some answers will be purely rational numbers and some will involve irrational. Place all answers in simplest form. Okay, so we have four practice problems here. And we're to use the quadratic formula on all four. Pull out the values of A, B, and C. Again, and yeah, your equation needs to be in standard form. All four of these are already in standard form, where we have all our terms on one side and zero on the other. So x equals negative b plus or minus the square root of b squared minus 4ac all over 2a. This is 25 minus 24, because that's 12 times 2 is 24, so that's 1. And let's split this up. Negative 5, 6, plus or minus square root of 1 is 1, 1 sixth. So this is negative 5, 6 plus 1 sixth. Negative 4, 6, which is equivalent to negative 2 thirds. And negative 5, 6 minus 1 sixth is negative 6, 6, equivalent to negative 1. B. A is 1, B is negative 8, and C is 13. First two parentheses is the b value, negative 8. Following the 4 and the 2 is the a value. And the last parentheses in the numerator is your c value, 13. Negative negative 8 is positive 8. That's 64 minus 4 times 13 is 52. 64 minus 52 is 12. Split this up. It's 8 over 2 plus or minus, and simplify the square root of 12. We're thinking 4 times 3 is 12 and the square root of 4 is 2. Excuse me, 2 square root of 3 over 2. I'm going to go over to here. 8 over 2 is 4. Plus or minus these twos divide out square root of 3. So 4 plus or minus square root of 3 is our solution here. Again, there are two values. There's 4 plus the square root of 3 and 4 minus the square root of 3. Let's put this one back here and circle these. All right, and by all means, pause the video, do C and D on your own, then fast forward and check. be careful with the double negative here. That's going to be a plus. So it's positive 4 plus 40 is 44. So 2 over 4 plus or minus 4 times 11 is 44, and the square root of 4 is 2. 2 square root of 11 over 4. 2 over 4 reduces to 1 half, plus or minus, this 2 and 4 reduce to 1 over 2. So you write that square root of 11 over 2. And two solutions there, 1 half plus square root of 11 over 2, 1 half minus square root of 11 over 2. And D. Sixteen times 5 is 80 plus 64. I'm thinking 144. Yeah, 144. Again, if you, by all means, use a calculator, just put in 8 squared minus 4 times 5 times negative 4. Negative 8 tenths plus or minus the square root of 144 is 12. That's a perfect square, right? And, yeah, I'm going to leave this like this and say negative 8 tenths plus 12 tenths is going to be 4 tenths, which reduces to 2 fifths. And negative 8 tenths minus 12 tenths is negative 20 tenths, which reduces to negative 2. So there we have our two solutions here. And our last exercise, number 5, a shot put throw can be modeled using the equation y equals negative 0.0241 x squared plus x plus 5.5. where x is the distance traveled in feet and y is the height, also in feet. How long was the throw? Oh, so we have to find the distance traveled once the shot put has hit the ground. So we replace y with 0. Put 0 in there, and now we have this quadratic equation that we want to solve for x. So our a value is negative 0.0241, b is 1, and c is our 5.5. So x equals negative b plus or minus the square root of b squared minus 4 times a times c all over 2 times a. There's no rounding here. I guess we're going to go to the nearest foot. Yeah, we're going to say to the nearest foot. So we're throwing this whole thing into the calculator. All in one step, not multiple steps. So calculator. Alpha y equals negative 1 is simply negative 1. right? I'm going to do plus first the square root of, well, 1 squared is 1, minus 4 parentheses, negative 0.0241 times 5.5, all divided by 2 times negative 0.0241. That gives me a negative value. Negative 4.91 something. Go up, arrow up, grab what we keyed in, arrow over and up until we change the plus to minus. Make sure it's subtraction, not the negative. 46.41. Something. Okay, so to the nearest foot, how long was the throw? 46 feet, we'll say approximately. I thank you very much for your attention.